that as a secretive bird on me. Trying to get a video of him for a long time.
There he is, there he is.
Got him. Must be a worm eater with that long beak. I got plenty of worms here for you. That's what you're eating. Wow. I've been chasing trying to get a video of this bird for a couple years. Guess he's finally getting used to me. Container that we use to put our kitchen scraps in. That's the bowl that I use to wash vegetables off in so that I can save the soil, throw it back in the garden. This is going to be my meal for today. There's a parsnips, little piece of horseradish root, wild leeks or ramps, ha gobel, and my grandma's spring onions. Fry those up with eggs. Something that nobody's ever seen before. A coffee cup filled with coffee. I like this green coated vinyl cloth because it doesn't rust. And I'm also installing a framework here over the top. I'm gonna drape chicken wire over this bed so the woodchucks can't get in it. And also that'll serve for me to be able to put my hand on it and I can reach down into the bed and support me as I reach into the bed. Multiple functions. Little catbird's back. She's hunting. This pawpaw really wants to put on a show this year. The tree is loaded with blossoms. Can you see the baby rabbit? I had to move around before I could get its eye in the picture. Oh, look at that, he's got a nose that's moving too. Probably got fleas. Not a lot of food around here. Siberian peaches on full display. yet another year of high production. Canadian plum that I originally bought. It's the first one. And after I bought it, a couple years later, I read, oh, you need two for cross-pollination. Oops. So I bought five more, and two of them are alive. This is the other one. Yeah, it's blossoming. Ain't gonna let me grab it. Hold the camera at the same time. And here's the third one. It's gonna blossom too. Uh-oh. This is a brand new crop for me. This fell on YouTube. Terrible gardening. He grew some last year and it turned out to be pretty nice, so I'm gonna mimic him. What I'm interested in is, are the slugs going to be repelled by the mustard? The allelopath substances in the mustard. I know. Be interesting. Notice the little circle that I scuffed up? There are five seeds. In each of these little scuffs, you can see a seed right on the top right there right now. I've tried this Landrace Polish root parsley before with varying, mostly poor results. I'm going to try it again. I've grown these beets before with terrific success. See, I've already got them planted. Five seeds per scuff, like the other two. I got scuff marks all the way. They're getting closer together now because I'm mixing them together. A diversity of plantings. There's some more beets. Beets are easy to see. Those little parsley seeds, they're very hard to see. Oh, there you can see some little ones right there. Right here's one. There you can see one right there, parsley, root parsley seed. Above ground plant. Final additions. The onions I planted in the front on the sun side, just a lineup of them. And the peas are all scattered around in the back. You can see the little holes. You see a pea in there. This whole half a bed is loaded with those peas. We'll see how it goes. I left the seeds exposed for about an hour. And now I spread compost over the top of all of them. Now when I was gone for an hour, and when I came back, there was a little bird in the bed over there. So I have to keep an eye on the seeds there, whether there's any left to sprout. Might have to reseed it. Must remain vigilant to keep that bed watered till the seeds sprout, till they poke their heads above the compost. Normally that's every morning, a watering, but if it's hot and sunny and dry in the afternoon, I'll water it twice a day. There aren't any carrot seeds in there. There aren't any seeds in there that take a long time to sprout, so probably within a week we'll start seeing them poking their heads up. This bed is next. Not really, they just come out. It knows I'm hauling its neighbors out, so it's putting in deeper roots. So I'm going to trim off the stalks and I'm going to replant them. I already got some of them growing over there. Garlic bulb that I did not harvest in the fall, and it sent up five brand new shoots out of each of its cloves, and now they're going to be pretty densely packed, and in my experience I get smaller bulbs, smaller cloves when I allow that to happen. But for comparison's sake, we're going to leave that in. And here is a lineup, you can see right on the edge, here's a lineup of those garlics that I pulled out and trimmed the roots and the tops. Likewise on this bed, these are trimmed ones. There's some trimmed ones off the in the distance, and then I transplanted some and didn't trim them. And we can see what kind of difference that makes. All trimmings added to compost. Time for breakfast. Skirt root, onions, garlic, skirt tops or shoots, black viper root, shoots and roots. It really did look like rain. but it hadn't. I watered it myself. I have to keep that moisture on this bed now until they start to sprout. I had a little baby squirrel. That's really little. There's his little hand. It's the last day or two of April. I think I had a carrot go to seed right here. I'm not trusting my memory, so I'm not sure. Ooh, this is more garbage. Hardware cloth walls, chicken wire roof. I've got this brace in the middle now. Last year I didn't have that brace, and when the woodchucks got on top of it, they sunk it down. Bent down the plants, and some of them they were able to eat. And I had this kind of haphazardly attached. I would just squeeze the chicken wire over it, and it was, you know, okay, but as an experiment, I tied these poles to it, and now the poles weighed it down. And if I want to get in there, all I have to do is lift it. And I've got poles on this side that aren't attached, so I can lift this and just bend it right in half over the top. Same thing with that side, bend it this way. Weighed down this raspberry cane. Bent it over. Now I'm expecting all these shoots to come up, straight up, to reach the sun. And when they're all up, I'm going to bury this whole cane in the ground. And then all the shoots, I'm expecting for them to grow roots. I'll turn one raspberry cane into, I don't know, there might be a dozen there. But do the same thing next year. 12 times 12 is 144.
My backyard is entering the time frame of it's nice to come out in the morning. Listen to all the wildlife, mainly birds, and watch all the growth. Now, did you get that? It isn't time that's as important. It's the backyard full of life.
We had another rain last night. Now I'm not concerned with watering this bed, newly planted with garden seeds.
You definitely have bud break.
Old friends are back. They move so fast I can't get a video of them. Generally those are the females that are making that noise. Female house wrens are back. And they're right here in the mail. Male house wren. Looking for a lovely lady. I don't remember hearing that tweet before. Number of pots I'm going to be planting these seeds in. I realize I don't have any lettuce seeds. I'll have to go buy some from the local store. That's a hunter. There's little birds all over my brush piles. They're hunting. We don't have many places to hunt here in the city.
Ooh, there's a different one.
Ooh. Had a red, little bitty bird with a red crest on its head. Where'd he go? Where'd he go? They're all in there. There might have been 20 of them in that little brush pile. They just kept coming out. I set out my chicken wire contraption. It works pretty good. You can see that's the pole that's connected to the end of the chicken wire to hold it in place. When I drape it over this hardware cloth, and I had some beach sand here. I put little indentations in the soil between these leaks, put the sand in it, and now I just spread carrots. The carrots are on top of the sand. The sand is wet. I think those carrots are already benefiting from the moisture. I'll let them sit there for, I don't know, half an hour, maybe water them in a little bit, another half an hour, then I'll cover it with compost. These are the three carrots. Let's see, let's put it in order. The bottom row of, I got three distinct lines of sand pockets. Now on the very top, I got the coral. And then in the middle, I got cosmic purple, and that's gonna distinguish between the three carrots. These are purple, the other two are orange. And then on the bottom, I put in these. They're supposed to be fast. Great as both baby-sized roots and fully mature. All I gotta do is drape this pole back over the top after I'm finished with the watering and the composting. And it's done deal. For breakfast, we have spring onions, which are not gonna be palatable here in another couple weeks. Dandelion flowers, ramps, a little shoot of rhubarb, asparagus, hot gobo, garlic mustard, and garlic shoots. Finished the next chicken wire covered garden bed. This one's a little bit differently configured in that this is a high ceiling. I've got some 24 to 30 inch peas planted in the back of it. But I'm not afraid of the woodchucks. I don't have to kill everything to grow a crop. Service berry blossoms. Next garden bed chicken wire roof project. This is the first one that I finished. It's good to go. Got the carrot seeds planted in with the leeks, so companion plants. I was wondering where these holes came from, now I know. I pruned the heck out of this cherry tree this last winter. And it's responded. The tree is loaded with blossoms. Siberian peach blossoms are spectacular. I have quite a few trees in blossom right now. Here's another peach, but that's not Siberian. I got a little sickly little blossoms this has. Didn't take long and all these raspberry shoots are pointing up now. A couple more days and I'm gonna plant this entire cane underground and let just the leaves stick above the ground and they'll grow roots. And I'll have lots of raspberry plants. Jostaberry bushes that never had this many blossoms. Another warm day today. It's supposed to be cold and rainy tomorrow. Maybe I'll put together a video of all the happenings of the last couple days. So, it's just too nice. We need to have a couple of cold, rainy days.